What do you do if you don't have enough memory for your data set? As a data scientist, you've experienced this before. You try to load your data and then it crashes. In other words, you're trying to read your CSV or Parquet file into a pandas data frame, but you don't have enough memory. Here are three solutions. Solution number one, swap space. Using the free command, you can see I have 2 gigabytes of swap space. I will go ahead and increase it to 8 gigabytes using the swap off, fallocate, make swap, and swap on commands. Now my data will load into a pandas data frame using main memory and swap space, but this means my data frame is spilling to disk and disk IO is multiple orders of magnitude slower than reading from memory. Also, it took about half a minute to load this Parquet file. Solution number two, stratified sampling. If I try a bit of feature engineering, I run out of memory and swap space. I can sample the data, but I need to make sure I'm stratifying my sample to ensure my pandas data frame represents the population as best as possible. This is a pain and not ideal, especially if I'm trying to gain as much information from the data as possible. Solution number three will leverage GPU memory. If you're using Google Colab or Kaggle notebooks, this is already natively supported. Otherwise, go to rapids.ai, click install, choose your parameters, copy the installation command and run it on your system. Google Colab shows you main memory and GPU memory usage here. Kaggle notebooks show it here. The open source NV dashboard has the same profiling capabilities. I will add it with pip install jupyterlab_NV dashboard. In my notebook, you will see the NV dashboard icon here. Click it and then click machine resources and GPU memory. I like to arrange them like this. Back in the notebook, all your existing code stays the same, except we run this load ext cudif.pandas magic command before we import pandas. Now when I read my Parquet file into pandas, you can see GPU memory fill up all the way, but spill into main memory instead of swap space or disk. This is ideal and also more than twice as fast to load that same 1 billion row Parquet file. Now I can focus on analyzing my data, feature engineering, without worrying about infrastructure, dealing with stratified sampling, or memory constraints. What we are showcasing here is the unified virtual memory feature of NVIDIA's open source library cudif, which is the NVIDIA CUDA acceleration library applied to data frame technologies like pandas, polars, and Spark. Unified virtual memory creates a single virtual address space between CPU and GPU memory for faster data processing, but also has the GPU memory oversubscription feature that we just demonstrated. I hope you try it out for yourself, and as always, cheers and happy coding.